Hi, everybody. I'm Melanie at Minnesota Title. Most of you know who I am. And today I have with me Laura Schuneman. She is in our abstracting department at Minnesota Title. And a lot of people don't really realize what abstracting does and understand its role in the whole title process. So Laura, what can you tell us about the abstracting department? What do they do?
So what we do is we take each property that we are given and we complete the searches for exams to create title work off of. So that would include finding warranty deeds, open mortgages, mortgages that might've already been paid off, but the satisfaction was never recorded. Make sure that the property is free of any previous owners that have been vested into it.
Okay, that makes sense. So what are some of the tricky things that can come up when you're doing your job that people don't realize can actually happen?
Well, you'll sometimes have mortgages that have been satisfied, but no satisfaction was filed. So from our point of view, it's not taken care of. It's still an encumbrance on the property. We run into properties that have documents that don't belong to them, that when somebody brought in the mortgage to be recorded, they filed it on the wrong property. Or we'll run into a couple gets divorced and they'll put the divorce decree, but it doesn't cover somebody being taken out of title, since usually one person or the other has a property that goes to them. You'll run into every once in a while where they just disappear and never sign away their rights. So technically they still have rights.
So what happens then if they're both still on there and you know they're divorced, maybe one of them even moved out of state? Do they have to like come back and sign off on the property? How does that work?
In some situations, yes. A lot of attorneys have gotten smart when they're writing the divorce decrees. I mean, and majority of them are written that so-and-so wins the property, and if they won't do a quitclaim deed, the judgment decree counts for the quitclaim deed.
Okay.
But you'll find the random one here and there where it's not added in there, and then we have to either contact the attorney who created the paperwork, see if they can help to figure out how to get this person to remove their interest.
That's awesome. And so another thing I heard you mention in the past too is the importance of like knowing the middle initial of people's names. Why is that helpful?
Yes, that helps tremendously, because we, in abstracting, will search out state and federal tax liens, judgments, and bankruptcies. So when we're searching these, you think of the common name John Smith, you know, we have times we'll have 17, 18 pages of results. So we have to provide all 17, 18 pages to our exams team, who then has to try and narrow it down of which applies and which doesn't. So when we do the initial search, it helps tremendously to have the middle initial. I mean, right, you're still going to have a couple that are questionable, but it'll narrow it down significantly and then save everybody time and money, right?
Exactly. And that's what we're all trying to do. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much for telling us a little bit about abstracting. If there's ever any questions on abstracting and what they do, post a comment or a question below, and I'll be sure to ask Laura for you, since I know no answers about abstracting. Thanks again. Have a good day. Bye.